الحمد لله الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله وأعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن سلك طريقهم وسار على نهجهم ودعا بدعوتهم إلى يوم الدين أما بعد فاتقوا الله عباد الله واتقوا يوما ترجعون فيه إلى الله ثم توفى كل نفس ما كسبت وهم لا يظلمون. My brothers and sisters, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for gathering us together in this beautiful house of His in the city of Kuala Lumpur. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless every single one of us and to grant us goodness, to bless entire humanity. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us all and grant us happiness in this world and the next. Brothers and sisters, the life that we have is very temporary. None of us lives for longer than a few years. This itself is a sign that this particular life has been brought forth by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for a purpose. There is a reason. If it was eternal, perhaps it would be different. But the fact that it is so short, some have lost their lives in infancy and others in childhood, some during their teenage years, others in their 20s and 30s, and some have been allowed to live a little bit longer. But ultimately, مِنْهَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ وَفِيهَا نُعِيدُكُمْ وَمِنْهَا نُخْرِجُكُمْ تَارَةً أُخْرَى. Allah says in Surah Taha, we have created you from soil or dust, and we shall return you back into the dust, and then we shall resurrect you from it once again. And this shows us that we are from Allah, and we will return to Allah, whether today, tomorrow, or at some point, even if we live for 150 years. But there will come a stage when we have to go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. From this we must understand that no matter how much I may love my family members, my children, my parents, my brothers and sisters, Allah loves them more because He made them in the first place. So no matter how much I love my son, I need to know that Allah loves him much more than I do. I cannot even compete with the love that Allah has for those whom He has created. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala love us all. Ameen. My brothers and sisters, the mistake we make is we think that Allah does not love us or our offspring or children, or sometimes we think that we love them more than Allah. So we forget about the test of life. And we forget that Allah says, إِنَّمَا أَمْوَالُكُمْ وَأَوْلَادُكُمْ فِتْنَةً. Indeed, the wealth that we have given you, everything material that we have given you, and your family members, your children, are a test for you. It is a test. Imagine, the beauty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His wisdom and knowledge has dictated that in order to bring people onto the earth, He will use what is known as parents, so that they may protect those children and they will feel the link and bond, so that they may nurture, they may spend on the children, and they may protect them from that adverse environment that may be affecting them time and again. If we had to grow like plants, I wonder whether we would have a connection with one another. Today you feel for one another because Allah chose for us to be created via other human beings whom we shall call our parents. This is why Allah says, وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ of life, Allah says, Allah has declared and dictated that you shall worship none but Allah. You shall worship none but Allah, and you shall be kind to your parents. You shall be kind to those whom that Allah who created you has chosen as a means for you to be here in this earth or on the earth. And this is why utmost importance respecting your parents, whether they are Muslim or not, whether they are part of the same faith or not. Respect is a duty upon us all, and kindness too. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to understand the status of our parents. So one might ask, well then why did Allah make us? What is it all about? Allah has created us for a short period of time in this world in order to test us. This whole life is all about a test. You have young children, subhanAllah, their test only commences in a big way, or should I say their responsibility unto Allah, at the age of puberty or maturity, when they are to fulfill the obligations that Allah has placed on their shoulders. But up to that age, they are a test for their own parents, for their siblings, for the community, for the rest of humanity. May Allah grant us ease. Today you are seated in front of me. Part of your test is how you shall be treating one another, how you shall be respecting one another, how you will facilitate for one another, and how you will create ease in every single way, and how you will protect each other from harm, and how you will make sure that you protect each other from that which is detrimental, that which will be a means of sadness for the other. That is part of your test and mine. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us all. My brothers and sisters, as we grow older, the test then becomes our own, whereby, have you fulfilled the responsibilities unto your Maker? What is He asking you for? Listen to what He says. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ مَا mankind or jinnkind except that they worship me. Which means the test for mankind and jinnkind is that they worship Allah. Now during our lives we will need sustenance. Many of us would need wealth. We are looking for money so that we can afford the plate of food and we can put it inshallah for our offspring, for those who are under our guardianship, for those whom we are responsible for. So sometimes we can lose track of the worshipping of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because of the devil who tries to deviate us just because we want to earn some money. So Allah says, I have created mankind and jinnkind for no other purpose besides that they worship me. I do not want from them sustenance. Allah doesn't want for us to feed Allah. Astaghfirullah. A'udhu billah. May Allah safeguard us from evil thoughts. He does not want from us to feed Him. But He has kept a test within us to feed those who are underprivileged from amongst our own kind. Subhanallah. And to be kind even to animals. And to be kind to all sorts of the creatures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Reach out to anything that has life. Fi kulli kabidin ratbatin ajrun. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, to feed or reach out or quench the thirst of anything that has a liver, any living animal or any living creature, will be an act of reward for you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala use us to reach out to one another, to help the homeless, to help those who don't have food. Whenever we eat, remember, never be wasteful. Never be a person who is ungrateful. There are others who don't have food. And sometimes the leftover that we throw in the bin might feed a whole nation. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the understanding. So Allah says, I don't want sustenance from you. And I don't want you to feed me. I am the one who will sustain you. Worship me alone. Call out to Allah. This is part of the test of Allah. Why is sustenance being made mention of when such an important point is being highlighted by Allah? Because many of us can be deviated by the devil because of money, because of sustenance, because of health, because of material items. So Allah is saying, hang on, your life is so short, don't waste your time doing that which will displease me, Allah says. Don't. You want wealth? Well, if you do it the wrong way, or if you do it the right way, remember, whatever I have allowed you to achieve, that is the only amount you will achieve, and that is the amount you will be able to use. Some people amass a large amount, but they will not be able to use it because Allah has chosen for them to leave this world prior to their ability to use that wealth. What was the point? This is why being happy is part of passing the test of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every time in life, Allah has told us very clearly, you will never ever have your life exactly as you want it, but we will make sure it happens according to us. When you have a test at a college, do you choose the questions, or does the examiner test the questions, or choose the questions? It is the examiner. So Allah is the one who decides how to test us. Every single one of us, without one exception, has had some form of a health matter in his or her life. Sometimes from infancy. The child has colic. That is a test for the mother and the father. The father sometimes loses his temper. On a little child, the mother wants to really break the head of the child. If that's the case, you have failed your test, my beloved mother. May Allah grant you ease. Remember to be calm, it's your test. Part of your paradise is to be patient upon the test that Allah has chosen for you. This is your child. So this is part of the test from infancy. And thereafter, as the child grows, sometimes there is sickness and illness. May Allah grant cure to all those who are sick and ill. May Allah grant cure to those who have diseases that medicine has termed terminal. In the eyes of Allah, nothing is terminal. Remember, the fact that we are living on its own already would lead us to understand that a day will come that we all have to go. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. So my brothers and sisters, let us ponder for a moment. None of us have had, just from one angle, one aspect, the aspect of health, none of us have had 100% health from the point of birth up to the point of us being seated here right now. It's either a cough, it's either we need glasses to see, it's either something, a flu, it's either something more serious, whatever it is, these are the tests of Allah. Your duty, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made very clear, احرص على ما ينفعك واستعن بالله ولا تعجز وإن أصابك شيء لا تقل لو أني فعلت كان كذا وكذا قل قدر الله وما شاء فعل. Make an effort to achieve what is beneficial for you. So if I get sick, may Allah protect us all from sickness. Allah has kept the capacity in me as part of my test to seek medication through halal means. I am not allowed to engage in that which will displease Allah. If I am sick and ill, I must do something about it within the capacity that Allah has bestowed upon me. He gave me the ability to go to the doctor. He gave me the ability to purchase some medication. He gave me the ability to do so many things. I need to do that, but in the name of Allah. It is Allah who allowed me to do that. So I will use His name and I will ask Him to grant me barakah and blessings in the effort that I'm about to put through His permission. Whether or not I am cured, ultimately is in the hands of Allah. Some people, they might have a small paracetamol, they will be cured. Whereas others might go through sophisticated medication and they are not cured, because that is the choice of Allah. It is the test of Allah. But your test was, did you do what was in your capacity, and did you call out to Allah alone, or did you engage in that which Allah had prohibited? May Allah grant us ease. This is just one test I'm talking about, and that is the test of health. And then the hadith that I just recorded a few minutes ago continues to say, seek the help of Allah and don't give up hope. To become hopeless, my brothers and sisters, means you are insulting Allah. Allah is the owner of all hope. one thing. If you have hope in your Maker, you have understood that ultimately He owns you totally. He is the owner of myself and yourselves. Imagine if you own a motor vehicle, you drive it as you please, but you are responsible. When it comes to Allah, He owns us completely. He can do as He pleases. لا يسأل عما يفعل وهم يسألون. He is not questionable. He is not answerable regarding what He does. But we are all questionable, meaning we can be questioned and we are answerable for whatever we do. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestow His blessings upon us. So the hadith continues to say, when something happens to you thereafter, remember, do not say, if I did this, then that would have happened. And if I did that, then this would have not happened. Say, this was the destiny of Allah that was predestined and He chose it that way. I am happy with the decree of Allah. That is how you will progress in life. My brothers and sisters, the test of life is manifest in the fact that we are going to die. Very clear that there is a test. If it was something that was beyond that, perhaps we would have lived forever and ever. And this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, when you pass your test and when you have your results, we will give you your results either on your right or on your left. فَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوْتِيَ كِتَابَهُ بِيَمِينِهِ فَيَقُولُ هَا أُمْقَرَأُ كِتَابِيَهُ. On that day, the one who will be given his book on his right hand, he will be so happy, so excited, he will say, hey, here is my book, read my book. May Allah make us from amongst those who get their books on their right. And as for those who get their books on their left, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَيَقُولُ يَا لَيْتَنِي لَمْ أُوتَ كِتَابِيَهْ وَلَمْ أَدْرِ مَا حِسَابِيَهْ. They will be so upset and they will say, oh Allah, oh, I had hoped that I did not get my book on my left, and I hope I didn't even know what my results were. Imagine when a person has written an examination at high school or university and they know they did bad. What will happen? They don't even want to know their results. The same applies when a person has done badly in this world, and on the day of judgment when they are given their book on the left, they will say, I hope that I didn't even know my results. May Allah never do that to us. We still have hope in the mercy of Allah. We try our best. Try your best, my brothers and sisters, and inshallah leave the rest to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Try your best. Don't lose hope in the mercy of Allah, because Allah has uttered that and said that in several places in the Quran. One of the most powerful of verses, Allah says, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. O Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tell them, O my worshippers who have transgressed against themselves, O my worshippers who have oppressed themselves, never ever lose hope in the mercy of Allah. Allah will forgive all your shortcomings, for indeed He is most forgiving, most merciful. Amazing. May Allah forgive us. What great hope. Imagine, you've written the wrong answer in your examination and Allah is saying, no problem, just apologize and just say, I'm sorry, admit that you were wrong, and we will sort the correct answer out for you. Subhanallah. Amazing. Who would do that? That is the mercy of Allah. But the test of life, my brothers and sisters, takes us to various places. Some are tested in a big way from the very beginning all the way to the end. Some are not tested for many years and suddenly a huge test comes in their direction. Remember, it is only if Allah loves you that He tests you with the big tests. Listen to what Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has told us. إِنَّ اللَّهَ إِذَا أَحَبَّ عَبْدًا إِبْتَلَاهُ. When Allah loves a worshipper of His, He tests him. Amazing. He tests him. And He will test such a person more. عِظَمُ الْأَجْرِ مَعِظَمِ الْإِبْتِلَاءِ. The greater the test, the greater the reward. The greater rewards are with the greater tests. We know that. even from an educational point of view. I'm drawing the parallel so that we can understand and realize. So when you write a massive examination, you ask so many people, please say dua for me. Please make a little prayer for me. I'm writing my examination today. I'm going for my road test. I'm doing this and doing that. The more difficult the exam, the greater the certificate. Amazing, amazing. Remember with us, Allah has created us in a unique way. He knows better how He has created us. But we know a little bit, some of the revelation that He has revealed to us, and we understand His plan. Let me give you one simple example. If I had no sickness, no problem, and nothing negative at all in my life, no test whatsoever, do you really think I would be able to worship Allah sincerely without shedding tears and so on? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala draws us closer to Him through the tests that He places in our life. This is why the weakness of man is such that when he has no test, he sometimes is led astray by the devil. He's so happy because to him he is in a little paradise. But when Allah loves him, Allah taps him with a test and with some negativity. So in a few moments, the person begins to call out to Allah, Ya Allah, help me. What made you call out to Allah? It is because you have a problem today that you turn to me. Allahu Akbar. I gave you the problem because I love you so much that I wanted you to come close to me. Now that you are coming closer, you are crying for me. You have got up early morning when everyone is asleep and you are worshipping me so sincerely. Because you have a health problem, I think I'm going to keep you in this condition because you are so, so close to me. Allahu Akbar. But we would say, that's not fair, O Allah. How can you keep me sick and ill? I'm calling out to you. But Allah says, as soon as I return your health to you, you may go back and you may forget about me. Verses of the Quran prove this. Subhanallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us ease. This is why it is reported that a person who has been tested and afflicted with the tests such as health matters and sickness, when they see the great massive reward on the day of judgment, they will say, Oh Allah, why didn't you keep us sick for the rest of our lives? Subhanallah. Why didn't you keep us ill or in that condition for longer? We came so close to you, our status was elevated. My brothers and sisters, the answer is sabr. Bear patience. Remember, bear patience. It is Allah's plan. Ultimately, I have to return to Allah. May Allah make it easy the day He chooses to take me away or you away. Ameen. May He make it easy for us. It is of utmost importance to also note, and I mentioned it, I am repeating it with detail. To be happy with the decree of Allah, that Allah has chosen for you, that you are sometimes unable to do anything about. The sooner you surrender to the decree of Allah, the quicker you will be able to become closer to Allah, and you will be able to understand the plan of Allah in this world, and the sooner you will be able to continue with the rest of the short life that you have. Let me give you a little example. At the moment, the Ummah at large, humanity at large, and every sane human being on the globe is very concerned about what has happened to the Malaysian Airlines MH370. We are all praying, we all make dua, we feel the pain of those who are affected, and really we call out to Allah to help them and to help those who have been on that particular aircraft. What has happened, none of us may know, and perhaps we may never know. At the moment, there is a lot of guesswork that is going on. We ask Allah to safeguard us. We ask Allah to protect us. We shed tears in solidarity with those who are affected. But remember one thing, ultimately, we have to surrender to the decree of Allah. Allah loves those more than we will ever be able to love them. Allah knows where they are. Allah is the one who is responsible. Allah created them in the first place. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has kept it as a huge test for all of us. How is this going to affect your life positively? That is one item for certain that we can take away from the entire episode whilst calling out to Allah, Ya Allah, Ya Allah, return them to us miraculously. Ameen. Ya Allah, return them to us miraculously. You are the owner of miracles, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, we ask you every form of goodness and ease for them and their families, and for us all as an ummah. My brothers and sisters, what a big test. What a great test. The magnitude of the test. Each one in our lives goes through different tests. At the moment, we stand in solidarity with all the others. Remember, the day you have a test, the others will stand in solidarity with you. So it is up to you to make sure you utter responsible statements. You have hope in the mercy of Allah. We are mu'mineen, we believe in Allah. We believe Allah created in the first place. He is the owner. He is in absolute control of everything. It is Allah and Allah alone. And we also understand the term rida bil qada. To be happy at the decree of Allah. To be able to say, Ya Allah, you have chosen this for me, Ya Allah. I will not compete with your choice and your decision. Ya Allah, help me. I am weak. I am a human being. I try my best, Ya Allah. There is a limited capacity I have. Ya Allah, help me. Help me. Grant me a greater capacity, Ya Allah. Help me through these tests that I am going through. My brothers and sisters, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to create ease for us. Many of us have gone through so many issues, so many difficulties. Let me read for you one verse before I close. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقْصٍ مِّنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ الذين إذا أصابتهم مصيبة قالوا إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون. Allah says, we will definitely test all of you with a little bit of fear, with a little bit of hunger. These are different departments we can speak about, but I'm leaving it brief. We will test all of you with a little bit of fear, in whatever way it is, with a little bit of hunger, in whatever way it is, and in loss of wealth, loss of produce, loss of life. So you will definitely lose someone who is loved by you at some stage in your life, because Allah says that is part of your test. You have to be asked that question. It is like Allah asking us 1 plus 1. We have to know the answer. Allahu Akbar. We have to know the answer. Allah says, it is impossible for you not to have lost someone who is very, very close to you in your life, or you will be lost by those who love you equally. Allahu Akbar. So that is part of your test. The sooner you realize that this is returning to a better life, returning to our Maker, the eternal bliss, the life where there is no death thereafter. That is where they have gone and that is where we will go, those whom we love. May Allah make it easy for us to surrender to reality. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for every one of us and make it easy for those whom we will be leaving behind the day we die. Brothers and sisters, these are just part of the tests of Allah. That verse continues where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, give good news to those who bear sabr. Those whom, when they are informed of damaging news, when they are informed of news that is within the decree of Allah, when they are tested in that particular way, they are quick to utter the declaration, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. We indeed belong to Allah. We were always His. We came from Him. And we are all going to return exactly to the same Maker. May Allah make it easy for us all. And may Allah open our doors, brothers and sisters. This life is but temporary. Your problem will not last forever. The loss or the debt that you are in will never last forever. forever. The issue that you have will not last forever. It will come to pass and it will come to an end by the will of Allah. Continue calling out to Allah without losing hope. Continue trying to please your Maker. He knows you. He watches you. He is in control. He knows why He has tested you in a specific way. That is your test by the will of Allah. When you have your certificate at the end, you will be granted paradise, eternal bliss. May Allah unite us in paradise. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.
اللهم